Welcome to another KD Tips and Tricks video. This time it's basically just an update for the last video that I did where I used KD Source Build to build my own Plasma version. And in this case I built the stable version of Plasma, 5.18. It was back by the time it was like 5.18.3. Now 5.18.4 came out and might be interesting for some people to know how do I upgrade now from 5.18.3 to 5.18.4 using KD Source Build. So what I have here is the changelog. So you go to your release announcements of KDE 5.18.4 and you click on changelog, which will list all the packages or all the projects that got change. And what you have to do is just simply copy and or just add those packages that got an update to your list of KDE source build. And as you can see here, KDE source build and Blue Devil here, Breeze, Discover, KDE GTK config, K info center, built from the branch 5.18, and this should get me 5.18.4. And yeah, I have to go through all those lists here. Car wallet PAM, for example. So we'll type in car wallet PAM because it got an update. Quinn got an update, so I type in Quinn. And libk sysguard got an update, so I type in libk sysguard. It will only fix a build with Qt 5.15, so I actually don't need it, but let's just do it. And then Plasma Desktop, of course, got an update. Plasma Network Manager got an update. So what I will do here is just simply go to Plasma Desktop, Plasma MM, Plasma Workspace, and XG Portal KDE got an update as well. And this is everything I need to do for upgrading my system. Let's check. I think this is okay. And yeah, let's go to this desktop again and just execute it. And what it will do is just starting from Blue Devil, it will try to get XG Portal KDE is wrong. XG Desktop Portal KDE. So sometimes it helps to type in the correct one, XG Desktop Portal KDE. And then it should start building. I think this is the only one that I mistyped. Yes, it will start building, it would update and then compile. And you can see one file affected in Blue Devil only, because I think it's just a. You can see the remove old formatting, so it's only one file that is affected. So to also show discover two files affected, how many files were affected by the update, which is also pretty nice and interesting sometimes to know. And it will, yeah, then upgrade all of these things and will give me also an error message if something fails. And this may be interesting for some how I deal with error messages. In this case, libk workspace is needed. So I was thinking already there's something wrong with this. So I will put Plasma Desktop at the end when it comes to building, and the other things in front. And yeah. Okay, it starts from Blue Devil again. Could change this as well, but I think it's not necessary. You can see why it's trying to build Plasma Desktop. Okay, then we, I don't know, should follow the, and let's just build it like this. The list that I gave him, but maybe some dependency thing is like interfering. So build, we can see it's pretty quick when it comes to updating all this stuff, because not much changed in the source code itself, and also compiling, recompiling this stuff. If you have your KDE source and KDE build directory still in your home directory, it will be super quick in compiling and super quick in updating the source, and then of course super quick in compiling stuff. As you can see here, Plasma Network Manager, for example, is compiled in a few seconds. And same goes for Plasma Workspace, three files affected, and it's compiling, and it's also pretty quick in compiling because it has not have to compile everything at new, only the stuff that changed, which makes it, of course, a lot faster. Yeah, this is a nice little update for the last video I did. I hope you enjoyed this video. You can like, subscribe. I have more KDE tips and tricks videos. There's a whole There's a playlist available with KDE tips and tricks, and stay healthy, stay safe. Until the next time, see you.